So I've been covering a lot of mini PCs that are high powered, more like almost desktop replacements, but lacking discrete graphics. Well, here is something that is very low powered. This is from Geekcom. It is the Mini Air 12, and it's a mini PC that runs Windows 11 that's ideal for lighter tasks. And I'm talking about things like spreadsheets, documents, browsing, emails, that kind of thing. Video playback, a little media machine is what this will be ideal for, with its Alder Lake N100 processors. So it's very low powered. It's a 6-watt part, but they're running it up to 12 watts here with its power limit that they've set, Geekcom. And it does come with Wi-Fi 6 gigabit LAN and can run 3 monitors. And one of them could be up to 8K 30 hertz out of the Type-C port that does support video out. Now this model here does come with 16 gigabytes of RAM and 512 gigabytes of PCIe 3.0 storage.
So this is what they do include. We have this instruction leaflet. This goes over how you can gain access to the internals, how to put on that VESA mounting bracket, and a few other things. That is the bracket right there. We get some screws for it, a 45 watt power supply, which is nice and small, and an HDMI cable. So this is tiny. As you can see, it's very short here, the profile of it, and it does feel kind of like those Intel Nooks a little bit. The build quality is excellent. So there are the mounting points there for the VESA mounting bracket. We have these 4 screws to undo if you want to gain access to the internals, which I will show you shortly. Around the outside here is plastic. That there is metal. Plastic on the top with the Geekcom there. Now there's this little protector here that I will pull that off, get that and remove that, because you're supposed to do that anyway. It's just there in transit to protect it. Kensington lock slot. Here we have a gigabit LAN mini display out 1.4, HDMI 2.0. This Type-C port does support video out, that one, 4K 120 hertz, and 8K 30 is working with that. 2 USB Type A's 3.2 Gen 2s, and then we get another Type A here, 3.2 Gen 2, and this Type-C port, same speeds, USB 3.2, but does not support video out. That one is data only. 3.5 millimeter headphone jack with mic support, power on button with status LED. And there is our SD card slot, always good to see that. So the hot air is coming out the back here with that Alder Lake N100. It's only a quad core chip, and the max turbo is 3.4 gigahertz. Single channel only is what this supports. So it's for light computing needs only, this type of mini PC. Here are the internals. Build quality does look very good. You can see we've got a metal frame in the inside here. The Wi-Fi card, that is soldered onto the motherboard, so no upgrades there. And it's just this single slot here, so it's not in dual channel. That's one thing about these chipsets, that while they are a little bit better than the previous generations, it's only got the single channel support here. And this is our SSD, which we can upgrade, of course. So they're the two upgradable components, RAM up to 32 gigabytes, and you can insert up to 2 terabytes, should be working just fine there in this. And you can see they do have a thermal pad on the top of that, which is then applying a little bit of pressure and transferring that heat onto the back of that metal plate there. That's good to help cut down on any throttling. So this is the RAM spec they have used. The brand is ADATA. It's DDR5 4800, 1.1 volts. So let's take a look how the Mini Air 12 runs. Now, normally I would show you the BIOS in my reviews, but it's not really that great because all of the settings are locked down to us. So there really isn't anything to show you with the BIOS. So here you can see it is running Windows 11 Pro. You do need to run the Windows 11 updates to get yourself all up to date, of course. Our 16 gigabytes of RAM is, yes, running at the correct speed. So that's the 4,800 megatransitions, or here it's listed as megahertz, and the one single stick there. So single channel, that is all that the N100 does support. Now, looking in the device manager, you'll see that our SSD is from Lexa, and our wireless card here, this is Realtek. So it's Wi-Fi 6, which is good for this kind of spec. I'd expect this. I wouldn't expect really Wi-Fi 6E, which is slightly faster. And it does have Intel UHD graphics, of course. So that SSD benchmarked it. Here are the speeds for PCIe 3.0. It's not bad. Reads especially are good. The write's a little slower than expected. Being 512 gigabytes and PCIe 3.0. You do have a bit of space there, and it's so much better than what we used to get. Remember, it was just SATA 3 before, with the older spec, and before then it was eMMC storage, which was even slower. So I have run here a couple of benchmarks, just two, because it's very low end, it's low powered. This is really for office work, media consumption, stuff like that, point of sale machine. You can see the single core score scrapes just over 1,000 points there, and exactly 3,000 for our multi-core score here with Geekbench 6. I mean, it's okay. It's definitely a step up from what we used to see, but not really by much. The previous models here, like the old Celerons that we used to get and whatnot, would be getting in the 2000s or 2400, something like that. So it's a minor little bump up in performance here. And this is Night Raid 3D Mark integrated graphics test. And the reason I ran this is just so you can get an idea, but it does tell me that really it's on par with other systems too that have this same spec. They get very similar scores here. So the performance is as expected. It's not underperforming or overperforming in any regard there. So that's really what you want to see with this. Now it can play back demanding files here. This is native decoding that it does have. So ATVC, VP9, 10-bit, 4K. We'll see how that does run. You can see initially there are a few little stutters there in the beginning. And once it gets going, however, the frame rate stabilizes and that performance is good. This is 4K 60, so another demanding file. And that one seems to be running quite well. The start, as I mentioned in a few videos, is actually like in slow motion that part, but now it's running at the 60 frames per second. And yeah, that's good. It's not dropping any frames at all. So for a media device, if you're going to be using this for playing back videos, 4K, whatnot, it will be ideal for that. We do get reasonably good performance out of it. Day-to-day tasks too, I've found that everything seems to be quick and snappy. Start menu doesn't lag when it loads in. The performance is a bit faster than what you'd expect for this kind of spec of mini PC. About documents and spreadsheets. So this is another ideal use for a spec of PC such as this that's really only good for lighter tasks. So you can see scrolling through the spreadsheet, that's reasonable. I'm not noticing any huge slowdown or anything. I'll just do a very quick edit and it doesn't seem to lag either. So this is a medium-sized spreadsheet here and it seems to perform all right for that. So documents too will be another good use, emails, browser, and media playback for such a mini PC like this. Taking a look at our thermals now and the wattage, it's used up to 12 watts with all my stress tests. Now it is a 6-watt part by default, but Geekcom have said here 15 watts for our PL1 power limit and 25 watts. Now, when it is idle from the wall, you're looking at around 5 to 6 watts. So it's very light, okay? Power use consumption is just sipping away. And even under full load, just getting up to the 12 there, what I've seen from the wall meter is nearing around 22, 23 watts only. And that was when I was stress testing it with a bit of gaming 3D stuff there, pushing both CPU and GPU. So it is really low powered, thermals are good. Great fan noise too. Looking at performance here with a bit of gaming, Counter-Strike 2, lowest preset, it looks terrible, all washed out. Up against bots here in only 12, 13 frames per second. It makes it very difficult, even against these bots here, which are super easy to move about. Like here we go, here's a, okay, might be able to get just one kill, lucky there. But look at how incredibly choppy and laggy this is. So it's not a mini PC, unfortunately, for gaming. I expected this with the N100 chipset. I did test out Linux Manjaro with open source drivers, and unfortunately I ran into the issue of it not detecting the wireless card.
Recapping now, the Mini Air 12 has an excellent build quality, and I'd say it's on par with what I used to see with the Intel Nooks. It really is that good. It's almost like they are the ODM for Intel, or were, or using the same one. It's that good, the build quality. So it can be mounted on a bracket behind a monitor, so it's got that VESA mount that's included. And the power consumption, as I showed you of this model here, is very low. So it's great for that. It could be a little file server mini PC perhaps, or set this up as a server. Now the BIOS did not have any advanced settings whatsoever. You've just got the basic things like the boot order and that's it. There were no settings you could go in and tweak, like power limits or anything like that. So that's why I didn't show you that in this video. And it runs Windows 11 Pro, and it's 16 gigabytes of RAM, and the performance you get out of that little quad core for basic tasks, as I showed you. for spreadsheets, emails, media playback is all good. Now, with the VP9 codec playback that I showed you in Chrome, it was occasionally dropping frames, but really you didn't notice the 2 or 3 frames it would drop out of 60. You can't really pick up on that, so it was smooth enough there. Its weakness, as I expected out of a low-powered mini PC like this, is gaming performance. So 3D performance isn't its thing. So if you bought one of these mini PCs and you wanted to play, say, League of Legends with a really good frame rate or Counter-Strike 2, it is not going to happen. You really need to look at some of Geekcom's other mini PCs that do offer, say, Irix Xe graphics, something a little more powerful there, if you're after Intel, that is. So for those light kind of tasks, as I've mentioned quite a few times in this video, it is ideal for that. So thanks a lot for watching my review here of the Geekcom Mini Air 12.